Hello again, my name is Pellegrino and today I'm going to talk to you about data fundamentals. This is the first video of a series of videos that I'll be uploading over the next weeks. This series of videos are going to be about the courses that I took during my last 6 months here in the University of Glasgow. The first course I want to talk to you about is data fundamentals. Basically, this course was a refresher of some of the topics that you learn if you did an engineering degree, not to mention if you did a computing science degree. In my opinion, this was also the perfect introduction to data science, with very basic stuff, but very, very interesting and useful. And I think it's worth mentioning that this was by far my favorite course, not only because of the content of the lectures, but also because of the lecturer and the way he presented things. The lecturer was Dr. John Williamson. The way he explained things to us was simply amazing, with lots of examples and lots of code, which is my favorite part. But anyways, here in the university the courses are divided into lectures, and there is usually one topic per lecture, and that's the way I'm going to explain to you in the next videos. Starting with lecture 1. In lecture number 1 we saw how to work with NumPy, a practical library to deal with numerical data in the form of arrays, whether it be tensors, matrices and tensors. How to transform them by performing, flipping, slicing, transposing, and many more operations on them. And we also took a brief look at the concept of vectorized computing, which allows performing a single operation to multiple data elements to improve the performance of our code by taking the maximum advantage of our computers. For lecture number 2, we learned how arrays are efficiently stored in a computer. We also saw how floats, I mean the data type, is stored in a computer following the IEEE notation. And this enabled us to know what are the most common errors that could happen when working with them. Finally, we were introduced to the concept of higher rank tensors and how can we work with them efficiently using, again, vectorized computing. In lecture number 3, we were shown some basics of scientific visualization using matplotlib, a Python library to plot data. And we learned the language of graphics. What is a stat, what is a scale, what is a guide, a geom, a layer, and a facet, as well as which plots make more sense when dealing with different types of data. This also involves which colors we can use to correctly communicate our findings when working with data. The fourth lecture was about an introduction to linear algebra, its concepts, and how can we perform them using Python and NumPy. This is somewhat an extension of what we saw in the first lecture, but now with linear algebra in mind. In here, we review the basic operations that can be performed on vectors, the concept of norm, and more complex vector operations. By the end of each lecture, we review matrices and the operations that are defined for them, as well as some useful properties that we can use to make our computations faster and simpler. The fifth lecture started with a refresher of how graphs can be represented using matrices, whether they are directed or undirected, weighted or weighted. After that, we went back directly to linear algebra, where concepts like eigenvalues or eigenvectors appear. We reviewed their relationship to principal component analysis, or PCA. Following the topic of decomposition, we saw some decompositions of matrices. We also reviewed the concept of singular value decomposition, which is a way to decompose a matrix into simple forms that enable efficient computations on them. In lecture number 6, we started with the core concept in which machine learning relies on, that is, optimization. Optimization is the task of finding the optimal settings for a process in order to improve it. We saw the main parts of an optimization problem, that is, the parameters and the objective function. In this lecture, we also saw how constraints can be implemented into our parameter selection to make our optimization search more realistic and close to the real world. We focused mainly on iterative optimization, guided by heuristics that try to improve the performance of the algorithms behind them. Lecture number 7 was also about optimization concept, including the basics of how a neural network works, and how derivatives can help us in finding the optimal parameters using the gradient descent algorithm. We saw what differentiable programming is, and how can we use it to perform optimization. For lecture number 8, the topic was probability, starting from the basics, including the concept of probability mass function and probability density function. We also review what the joint, marginal, and conditional probability are, the basics for Bayes' rule, a very important concept, and how can we deal with probabilities without running into numerical issues. For the lab of this lecture, which was, in fact, very, very important, we learned what a stochastic process is and practiced using a specific version of this kind of process, the Markov process. In lecture number 9, which was also about probability, we saw the concept of expectation, then some statistics, and finally, what Bayesian inference is and how the Monte Carlo approaches are useful when dealing with Bayesian inference. To conclude with the course in lecture number 10, we saw a bit of digital signal processing and time series, what sampling is and its relationship to the Nyquist limit, and how aliasing can appear if we don't respect this limit. The last section of this lecture was about convolutions and the Fourier transform. Of course, we reviewed many more concepts and were more in depth in almost all of them. We're trying to summarize hours of lectures into one short video is not that easy. So if there is something that you want to learn more about, just leave it in the comments and I'll try to answer. So that's it for me, at least for now. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, you know, give it a like. There are more videos coming about the rest of the courses that I study. I'm creating them and uploading them as I'm reviewing the lecture in preparation for the exams. And I think the next one is going to be about machine learning. Well, as I said, that's it for me. Subscribe if you haven't done it yet, and I'll see you in the next video.